Imagine that you want to solve this seminal problem in geotechnics, but the soil is not a continuum. It is a dense packing of discrete particles, and the length scale of interest is comparable to the typical size of the particles. You have two alternatives. You can suppose that the soil is continuous, then allocate equivalent parameters for elastic moduli and density, solve the boundary value problem, and then you get the stress. Alternatively, you can follow a discrete approach, for example with discrete element method, and then you will see that the load is supported by a system of particle forces, and these forces can be transformed into stresses. However, each time that you repeat this experiment, you achieve a different system of interparticle forces, and hence you achieve a different stress field. So how can we deal with these two different approaches? One is deterministic, there is only one solution, and the stress field is smooth. The other is stochastic, because there are many solutions, and each time that you repeat the experiment, you achieve a different one. In addition, the stress field is not smooth, because the stress sharply changes from one particle to another. So what if we follow the discrete approach and we repeat the experiment many times to generate a statistical sample, and then we pay attention to the statistical distribution of the stress measured at any given point? In this article, a theory is presented. This theory is based on classical statistical mechanics, and it anticipates that the probability distribution function of the extensive stress of the particles in the principal direction of the stress field, that is solution to the boundary value problem, follow an exponential distribution in the case of normal components and a Laplace distribution in the case of shear components. The theory also anticipates that these PDFs are located and scaled by the solution to the corresponding boundary value problem. This theory has been validated by solving more than 5,000 times the same numerical experiment with the discrete element method. Then the stress was recorded at three different control points, and the normal and the PDFs of normal and shear components were compared to those predicted by the theory. If you want to read more about this theory, please check this article out. If you want to understand why an exponential distribution for the normal components of the stress, please watch the video with the story of the Tower of the Five Piles.